Shalawam, sister. Shalawam. Kol Hashem. Hamashiach. Malachi. How shy. All praise to the Most High. Lord willing, y'all had a beautiful day of atonement. I know I did over here. We pretty much just made a list of things that we need to work on. And the Watching for Israel brothers, they had a live stream at the school. And it was holding it down for 10 hours. I'm so proud of them. All praise to the Most High. So it was a beautiful, real beautiful day of atonement. I went over my list of things that I told y'all to do. Hopefully y'all did it. Whereas you wrote down, you know, the list of stuff that you need to work on. And then every once in a while, you go and check on that list to make sure, you know, you on top of what you need to be on top of. So that's pretty much what I did. I asked my sister and I asked my husband. I told them, we went over it. And they pretty much said it was cool. They was like, yeah, you know, you pretty touched everything that you need to work on. So I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful
tonight,
for them.
I'll be eating chicken masala with garlic now. Because I win again. Patrick.
Selecting.
That's
so. It's a commercial. Patrick. But yeah, we pretty much went over, you know, all the stuff
sir.
I went over all the stuff I need to work on. But Lord willing, the Most High put the Spirit on us to endure. And Lord willing, He forgives us for our sins, you know. Lord willing, He makes our sins as white as snow. And that, you know, He put the Spirit on us to, you know, keep enduring in this truth, to keep, you know, pretty much fighting that good fight, enduring and fighting that good fight, and, you know, wearing that whole armor. And Lord willing, He just have mercy on us and bless us with more knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, pretty much. And, you know, the Day of Atonement is really important to me. And hopefully, you know, I feel like I could have. But, you know, I'm hard on myself, so I ain't even going to talk about it. So, anyway, today I just wanted to do a quick little video because I got time. My kids sleep. Why not? And, you know, the Most High put the Spirit on me to do it. It's been a long time since I did a various topic video. But I just wanted to let y'all know, you know, pretty much what's going on, you know, with my life. Because I feel like, you know, it's relatable. I feel like my life is relatable. Just like, you know, we all pretty much go through or have been through the same things. There's nothing new under the sun, but right now, you know, I'm pretty much just want to tell y'all, like, you know, whatever y'all going through, you know, the Most High is doing it for a reason. He's doing it for a reason to strengthen you in the spirit. And, you know, if you ever need help, don't ever be afraid to ask anybody for help. Don't ever be afraid to ask anybody for help, whether it be your sister, your mother, you know, just don't be afraid. And I feel like I was once like that. Like, I would just be like, you know, I got it together. I don't need help with this. Oh, I got this. Like, that's how I was. And I realized that, you know, after I had my son, it's a lot with two toddlers and a newborn baby. And in the house, I literally have 4 bedrooms and 4 bathrooms. So it's a lot for me to clean up. It's a lot, you know, when they making a mess and I got, like, I'm the manager of the house. So I have to take care of everything in the house. So it's a lot for me. And my house pretty much went downhill because after my son was born, I literally started working. And it was like kind of like a nonstop. And I just was like, I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it anymore. I just said I need a break. And because my house was just, it was becoming too much. And that was the breaking point that I needed, where it was like, look, I have to ask for help. I have to ask my sister, you know, we all need to help each other out, you know. And even with sisters, like sisters in our congregation, like, we're always there for each other. If you need, you know, we're there. So hopefully y'all have that type of sisterhood, or you can find a type of sisterhood where you can have sisters come over your house, help you clean up, help you cook, help you take care of your children, whatever the case may be. You know, even if you don't even have kids and you're going through a situation and you're moving, or you're, you know, you're trying to find a job or whatever, just make sure you have somebody there, a good support system to help you through, you know, your trials and tribulations and the little obstacles that the Most High give you. I used to be afraid to ask for help, but not anymore. Not anymore, Salaki. I'm not afraid. Last week I had a client, and she was telling me, you know, it's so much. She was like, it's so much because, you know, she's a stay-at-home mom because of her children and because she has to work from home. So she's like, I don't even have time to clean up. And I'm like, tell me about it. Like, I know, like, it's hard. And she was pretty much saying that she had somebody come help clean her house. And I was like, oh, damn, that's crazy, for real. Because I've been thinking about it, because I've been looking on care.com. And long story short, it was all the Most High that she recommended to Eshakar's sisters. And they came over and they hooked it up. They pretty much set the foundation for me to really get my house in order. And I was feeling bad. Like, I was feeling real bad. I didn't even, honestly, when they was in here cleaning up, I didn't even want to go upstairs. I didn't want to be around, because I was just like, I'm like, y'all okay? Is it that bad? I keep asking questions. They're like, ah, you good? But I'm just like, you know, I was low-key kind of embarrassed, but I was like, you know, we had handmaids in the ancient world. We had help in the ancient world. We had that extra help. So if you need help, don't be afraid to ask. Don't be afraid to ask on sisters. Let me tell you something. WFI sisters, we the pull-up crew. We'll come. You send me a DM. You know, of course, I got to know you a little bit. But if we know you, send us a DM. We out there. All right? We got a whole little crew. We be out there. I'm trying to tell you. So, you know, unfortunately, with my situation, I didn't really want... I know sisters was real busy, and I wasn't about to ask, hey, can everybody come over and help me with my house? So I just had the sisters come over, and luckily my husband agreed to it, because before, he wasn't having it. But I was like, look, I pretty much kind of told him. I was like, this is kind of what's going on. And he was like, okay. So, you know, everybody was happy with it, and, you know, they're going to come every 2 weeks and help me. So, you know, and I'm not embarrassed, and I don't feel bad about it. Why? Because I need help. Shoot, you need help. But, you know, don't be afraid to ask sisters for help. Don't be afraid to ask for help, you know? You're going to stress yourself out not asking for help. Trying to do everything by yourself, trying to be that entire, complete superwoman, you know? What else? Pretty much, it's okay. It's okay to fall while you're striving for perfection. It's okay to ask for help. Yeah, and that's pretty much on that topic. Y'all, we getting so close to the end, and I just hope and pray that y'all enduring. You know, everybody's having so many crazy dreams, like just end time dreams and stuff like that. I just had a crazy one the other day, and this was the first dream, well, the third dream I was actually like real scared in. And it was like, I was walking with my husband, and it was just like, we always say this to each other. I know y'all say the same things to people y'all around, like, I'm ready to get up out of here. I'm so tired of this place. And then right after I said that, it was just missiles flying everywhere, like everywhere. And we was trying to cover ourselves, and it just felt so real. And it was chariots. It felt so, so, so real. And it was just like, dang, that's the Most High telling us, like, you know, all these dreams, like, people in my family and congregation have, and it's just like, that's really the Most High really telling us that, look, we're about to be up out of here, Lord Rhythm, but we got to keep enduring, because we don't know how long. Of course, we don't know how long, but, you know, that's going to be a scary day. It's going to be a terrifying day. It's going to be a terrifying day. And it's like, when it's time to get judged by Yahweh Shemayah Shai, he not playing no games. Everything that you say out your mouth, every thought that you thought, everything that you got going on, he's going to bring it out. It's going to be all put on the table. It's all going to be put on the table. And that's a thought that, you know, sisters should really meditate on, because that's scary. That's that little, you know, that light under, that fire under your butt that should keep you, like, you know, motivated to do, you know, to pretty much be righteous and to continue to strive for perfection and be blameless, because it's all going to get put out there. It's like coming home with a test. You don't really know how you did on it, or your report card. You don't really know how you did, but you tried your best, but you get it, and your parents open up in front of you, and it's either, hey, you did good. Yeah, you kind of did good, or you kind of just, you know, you was pushing it. You knew the truth, but you was just pushing it. You don't want to, you kind of want to be secure. You kind of want to be like, dang, you know, I did the best I did, you know, and I know, you just got to have faith that, you know, that you're going to make it to the kingdom pretty much. You can't, if y'all get what I'm saying, you can't just be like, I don't know, I was just winging it, I was skating it, here, you know, here's all my works. No, you got to be bold, and you got to be confident, like, look, okay, you know, I did this, that, and the third. I was righteous, you know, I taught my children, you know, to die for Yahweh Shemayah Shai, you know, whatever the case may be, you know, you just want to just stand bold in this truth, don't give up, and hopefully y'all get what I'm saying, just stand bold in the truth, don't give up, and just keep enduring, because, you know, when it's time to get judged, I might pass out. I don't know. We don't know what's gonna happen. I might pass out. I remember I had this dream where I don't even know if I ever shared this, but I remember I had this dream where I was in a ball and I was naked. I was in a ball and it was like real, it was like you heard footsteps, like, and you just heard the footsteps. And it was like I heard a voice, and then I remember I was scared. I was so freaking scared. And I remember I was trembling. I was so scared. I was just like in my dream, and I didn't want to look up. I didn't want to look up because I didn't want to know. I didn't want to see who it was. But they was talking to me, and it was pretty much giving me a list of things that I needed to do. And then I guess like I was going to, what happened? What happened in the dream? Y'all want to know what's crazy? I couldn't remember everything that they told me on that list of things that I needed to do because what happened? It was either I had lacked faith. I lacked faith in something. I think I was just like, I'm not going to remember anyway. So I think after that, that's why I couldn't remember it, because I told myself I wasn't going to remember it. And when I had woke up, I didn't remember it. Woo! And it's crazy, y'all, because I was just like, I don't know who that was in a dream. I was like, you know, it could have been an angel, could have been the Most High. And I was literally looking at my notes, and I was going over these flashcards with my son. And then I was thinking about who it was, and then I seen this. Ain't that scary? But yeah, it was real, real, real scary. And I was real troubled. I remember when I had woke up, I couldn't even, like, I couldn't get out of the bed the whole day. I was crying. I couldn't get out of bed. And I told my husband about it. I was like, yo, what was that? Like, that's crazy. Like, I was sick the whole day. Like, I remember I was real sick. And I just couldn't get up out of bed. I was pregnant with my son. I couldn't even get out of bed. I couldn't do nothing. I was crying, I was sick, I was sad. I was just like trying to figure out, it was a real troubling dream. And that pretty much like scared me and really made me like examine myself. Cause I don't know, it was real, 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 real crazy. You know, I don't know if that was the Most High or angel or what it was, but you know, at first I was, then after it happened, I was just like, that wasn't what I thought it was. And then one day it was thundering outside, and that same feeling I felt when it was thundering was the same feeling I had in my dream. And I was like, oh, that's the Most High. I was like, I knew that it wasn't just me tripping. I knew that it was the Most High. But yeah, that was the Most High. I don't know. Maybe he instilled it in my spirit of the things that I need to work on. And Lord willing, I I'm working on it, Lord willing. But yeah, you know, that day when you on this time to get judged, it's gonna be bad. It's gonna be a horrible feeling. If it's anything like having a dream where you think that the Most High coming to you, or that sound when you hear thunder, or that when you hear bombs drop, if you ever heard any of that before, or a crash, and you get your heart kind of dropped, it's gonna be like that. It's gonna be horrible. It's going to be horrible. It says, woe to you. Don't it say woe to you if you desire the day of the Lord? It's going to be horrible. I mean, he's going to be putting people to death left and right. Everything that you did, hey, it's going to be on the table out there in the open. But, you know, Lord willing, the Most High put the Spirit on us to really endure and to, so we can get up out of here. Get up out of here. The rumors of war, things is really heating up. It's heating up real bad. You know, and we can't ignore these things and act like it's not happening. You know, it's happening. You just got to deal with it. You got to deal with it, and you got to get yourself ready. You got to get your household in order. And when you got your household in order physically, then, you know, it's better with you spiritually to be more inclined to get your household in order spiritually, too, if you know what I'm saying. Like, when you have a nice, clean space and, you know, it keeps your mind clean. Keeps your, you know, when your stuff is organized, it keeps your thought organized. It keeps, okay, look, well, I got time to actually study. And you get a schedule and you get all your stuff together, you're going to be feeling good. You're going to be, you're going to be feeling real good. You're going to be feeling like, I'm all right. I'm getting my stuff together. I'm getting my house in order physically. I'm getting my household in order spiritually, etc. But yeah. you know, that's one of the topics I wanted to bring up. Like, it's just, we pushing it. Esau wickedness waxing worse and worse. They sins definitely didn't reach Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shah's definitely didn't reach heaven. People having crazy dreams. I mean, crazy dreams. People having crazy dreams. You got the rumors of war. You got earthquakes and just look at California. See what was going on in California? My sister-in-law, she called us when it was all going down, when the fires was going down. She was so scared, like, oh, I can't believe this. If they don't just tell us it's the end of the world, they should just tell us. The sky was just, like, burnt orange. My husband, he just seen a damn near a blood rainbow. We never seen that before. It was a rainbow, except for it was literally, like, blood orange. It was real crazy. It's like all of this stuff is happening. You know, the Most High bringing all these signs. Like, it's like, we got to get it together. Whatever it is that you got to work on, just work on it. I'm telling you, even if you got to fast. You know, and I feel like a lot of our problems is that we don't want to fast because, you know, we just want to be, you want to eat something good, you know, stuff like that. You want to drink something good. No, we need to be fasting. We need to be giving ourselves over to fasting. That fasting, man, you know, it can be hard sometimes, but Most High really hearken to your prayers when you fast. It's really that perfect magnifying glass over your prayers. And, you know, if you got trouble fasting, hey, just start eating one meal a day, breakfast, and then that's it. You know, Most High make it, you know, work for you where you build up your spirit, where you can start fasting more. Because, you know, it has to be done. You got to just stop. If you scared to fast for 2 days, you got to just stop. Just do it. Just stop what you're doing and do it. Just don't be scared. Ain't no point of being scared of doing it. Or, I'm hungry. No, give yourself over to the Most High. Right? That's all you need. That living water. Right? Open up your scriptures. Just take your mind off of it. Just continually take notes. You know? Give your mind, continually give yourself over to praying when you fasting, and really humble yourself, you know, in the sight of Yahweh Bashim Yahshai, so he can hearken to your prayers. Because we're gonna need that. We're gonna see some crazy stuff in these last days. We're gonna see stuff that we ain't never seen, stuff that ain't never happened on this earth that's gonna happen in the last days. And we coming out of Babylonian ways, like we coming out off of, from the, we used to watch a Disney Channel, Nickelodeon, we used to watch all this fairy tale stuff. No, it's about to get, all of that's out the window. It's about to get real. They kept us asleep for a long time. We up now, and we really got to know what's going on. We got to look at the times that we're living in. We really do. We got to look at these times, and we got to be like, look, I got to get myself together. I got to get my house in order. I got to get myself in order. I got to get my kids in order. I got to make sure my kids know what's going on. Like I always tell y'all, you got to let your kids know. Let your kids know. Let your kids know what's going on. Don't be afraid. I tell my son all the time. I'm acting like he over there. I tell my son all the time what's going on. And my daughter too. Like they all know. We talk about what death is, what the spiritual world is. You know, what it means to you know, go to the spiritual world when you die. When you die, you up in the sky, we how about Shemiel Shai? You know, then you're going to come back and you're going to rule. You know, they know everything. They know all of that. You know, I'm not afraid to let them know these things. And you shouldn't either. They need to know these things. But yeah, that's pretty much it, sisters. Like, you know, we just really got to keep enduring and fear the Most High. That's the most important thing, you know, fearing the Most High. You know, if you're struggling with something, ask a sister. Don't be afraid to ask for help. Don't be afraid to ask for help, because I know I was. I was afraid. I was like, oh, you know, I don't care. I don't want people to judge me. No, if you need help with anything, it don't even have to be around your house. It could be help with, you know, if you need somebody to fast with you, if you need somebody to pray for you. You better ask somebody. The prayer of a righteous man availeth much. So, you know, you ask a righteous sister to pray for you. Hey, you never know what could happen for you. You know? So don't be afraid to ask people to pray for you. Don't ever be afraid. Don't be afraid. If you're a sister and you need help around your house, don't be afraid to ask somebody for help around your house. They'd be like, look, I need you to come help me because I'm about to lose my damn mind. Don't be afraid. You know, it's a lot of, we all going through stuff. You know, if you need help with anything, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to reach out to me. If you live on the East Coast, look, we're going to make a trip. You know, we're going to throw up some prayers. We're going to be there. You know what I'm saying? If you ever need somebody, hit them up. Hit them up. Hit them up. Let them know what's going on. Don't be afraid to vent to sisters. Have that one close sister, you know, or a couple close sisters that you can, you know, have that one counselor, you know, that you can go to. You know, don't be afraid. That's all I'm saying. Don't be afraid to hit sisters up. Yeah, but most importantly, you know, just fear the Most High. Fear the Most High so we can get up out of this captivity, you know, so we can endure, you know. Like I say, always think about in the last days, like, you know, all the sisters and everything that, you know, everything that pretty much that we do, you know, in Israel, all the sisters that's doing stuff in Israel and stuff, I'm gonna be thinking about y'all. I'm gonna be thinking about y'all when, you know, when all hell breaks loose. I'm gonna be thinking about y'all. I'm gonna be praying for y'all that, you know, we make it out. That we all, you know, make it out to get the kingdom. You know, at least all the sisters that I, you know, that I talk to and all the sisters that I know that's enduring, like, I'm gonna be thinking about y'all. I'm gonna be praying for y'all. You know, Lord willing that y'all endure. Like, dang, I hope this sister gonna be alright. Hope that, you know, that's just how I am. I be thinking about everybody else but myself sometimes. But, you know, I'm just be thinking about everybody. Like, hopefully these videos been helping sisters. You know, hopefully sisters been hearkening to these videos and really just listening. You know, just stuff like that. I'm gonna just be thinking, like, I hope. But most importantly, hopefully I can continue to be profitable to myself. And just not a teacher and not be unprofitable to myself. The Lord willing, the Most High put the Spirit on me to continue to be profitable to myself and to my husband, my household. But, and Lord willing, y'all too, that y'all just not teachers and that y'all are profitable to yourself. Because you can be a teacher and then not be profitable to yourself, like the scripture said. Everything you say just out the window. You know scriptures, but you don't apply them. You know? And that's kind of prideful right there. But, long story short, sisters, fear the Most High, because that feeling, you know, that feeling, Most High, he not playing. You know, it's a real sick feeling. It's a real, real sick feeling. He not playing no types of games with us. He don't care who you are. He don't care. That's why I like the scripture when it says, if you think that you something, you ain't nothing. You ain't nothing. The Most High don't, you could think, you could say that you did this down the third in Israel. You didn't know. The Most High don't care, especially if you're not keeping the commandments. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta really endure, keep the commandments, keep pushing, fear the Most High. Like I said, if you need help, ask for help. And that's pretty much it, sisters. Love y'all. Shalawam. Keep enduring. And Lord willing, the Most High continue to dwell with y'all. Shalawam.